Hey everyone, Jeremy here with Bogren Digital. You might have noticed that our file names for our impulse responses are a bit different than what you would typically expect. Trust me though, there is a method to the madness and we're gonna go over that in this video, so let's get started. Most of the IR packs on the market today come with seemingly endless combinations of microphones, cabinets, mic angles, and that can be enticing, especially if you've had success in the past with a particular cabinet and mic in a mix. The problem with this approach though is that an SM57 on a Mesa cab can sound anything from incredible to just awful. Even when you compare packs between different manufacturers that use the same cab with a mic in a certain position, you'll notice the sound is quite different. And that's because a huge part of the tone is not just the equipment and a position. Building a world-class guitar tone is hundreds of small decisions that all come together to get captured in our IRs. We do not want you to be influenced by flashy gear names, because sometimes the ugliest microphone on the cheapest of guitar cabinets is exactly what your mix needs, and we don't want you to skip over something just because it doesn't have a name that you've heard other people use. Now, if you'd like to know more about our process and a little about what gear was used in our impulse response packs, stay tuned to the channel for future videos on these topics. All right, everyone, with that, we are gonna wrap up this video. We hope you found this information helpful. Let us know down in the comments below what content you would like to see from us in the future. Hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out. And as always, we wanna thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.